afternoon, everyone. Welcome back to AVX Live. I am Joe Gilderson, President of Corporate Audiovisual Services, and I am once again joined by Mr. Ryan Finch.
Easy, everybody. Calm down.
That is impressive that you have your own cheering squad.
Yeah, you know. Well, I mean, here we are at episode number 70, and I just feel like now's about time.
This might be the time to introduce that.
Do you know what else it's time for?
I'm not sure.
I think you know.
No, I don't know.
Music.
Oh, I thought we got rid of this.
Nope.
Can we come up with new music for 2023?
No, but we can make it louder.
I don't think that's a good idea. Yeah, that is wonderful.
Look at me. I'm like Artie Dillon.
You are not like Artie Dillon. You are not. So here we are approaching the end of 2022, and we thought we'd do a little recap of our AVX video podcast and our results for the year 2022. So we're pretty excited about that. Ryan has been working tirelessly on gathering this data.
Tirelessly would imply that I didn't get tired. I got tired. So that's a lie.
Because there was so much data.
It is a lot. It is a lot. And I've never had to sift through it like feverishly fast. Hmm. I'd prefer not to do that again. You never need quick answers with analytics, or typically. Usually you want long-term, decision-making answers.
Well,
I have no experience with those either.
Listen, Ryan, it's better to be doing something and to produce something than to wait and wait and wait, produce nothing perfectly. So I am excited to see this information today, and we're gonna have some fun with it. But it's kind of a fun concept and a great way to showcase how to use video and analytics in your marketing as well. But listen, first, before we get there, Ryan, why don't you tell people how they can find us and how they can watch this show more often?
I think actually after we finish with today's show, people are going to want to watch more often for the reasons that we're going to get into. But in any case, you can find us on Facebook, on LinkedIn, on YouTube, live, specifically live every Wednesday at 1 p.m. Eastern Standard Daylight. We talked about that last time. I'm not sure. 1 o'clock on your clock, and we are live. If you missed that, you can find the little bite-sized, chunked-up pieces of it on Facebook and on Instagram. And while you're on those channels, hopefully, whether it's live or pre-recorded, you can hit the like, the comment, the share, or the subscribe button. And if you're watching it live, drop a comment, be part of the show, ask a question. You might as well. I went completely out of order in that one. Completely out of order. Kept you on your toes. Way to go.
It's okay. I'm a pro. I'm used to just going with things. So it's no big deal. Mm. I mean, I didn't just walk in. No big deal.
I wish I had like a lie button. Like, that was a lie.
No, we're not doing that. Look, this stuff is fun. And there is a big difference between doing something live and pre-recorded. And so we've put really a lot of our efforts on our marketing side into the live. When we first started doing this 70 episodes ago, 70, we originally were thinking we were going to do this as pre-recorded, but it just takes so much time on the editing that at that particular moment in our cycle, as we were in the pandemic, a pretty high point right then, there just was not enough time to do that. So we said, you know what, we can go live. We're more interesting live anyways. Hmm. And here we are, and we're going to see if anybody who's watching actually agrees with us, or if it's just our opinion. What do you think, Ryan?
It really could go either way.
It's a little dicey, I'm not going to lie. This is like where the lawyer is supposed to know the answer to the question before he asks it, but I really have no idea what's going to happen next. So let's see what we got. Why don't we recap a little bit? Ryan, I'm turning the floor over to you.
That is foolish.
I know, isn't it?
I didn't do nearly enough planning for this. Well, Joe, I think we determined how many episodes we've done this year. Do you remember what that number was?
I actually do. We have done 35 episodes this year, and just doing some really high-end math, That means we did 35 last year as well.
We're nothing if not consistent. I bet if we went back and looked at what weeks we missed, it would be the same weeks too.
I'd be willing to bet they're pretty close, because the unfortunate part with live is that we also have many live events, and they always take the priority. So clients first, our fun and games second.
That is true.
But either way, that's pretty consistent, though.
I mean, it is. I feel pretty good about it. I mean, there's, 52 weeks in a year, and 35 of them we were live. So I guess maybe, not every Wednesday at 1 p.m., but most Wednesdays at 1 p.m.
High percentage.
Yeah. All right. Well, look, I think we should get right into it here.
That's 70%. I mean, you think about it, that's 350 hours of live broadcast experience you and I have gathered this year.
And if you double that, that's the amount of man hours that have gone into, well, or woman hours. There's more team involved.
I don't know if today counts as that.
No, well.
But there are other people involved, and you have to consider that. Right. If you decide to go down this road, you have to consider, you know, who else is going to be involved, because you have to create graphics, you have to create posts, you have to do some editing work afterwards if you want to use the infamous shark bites from our friend Andrew.
That's right.
You know, so there's other people involved, and they're all mission critical to the goal here. So, Ryan, let's get started.
All right. So we thought it would be – hold on. There we go.
Oh, so much better.
Let's get you out of here. We thought it would be a really, really good idea, and I still think it is, even after going through the process, a really good idea to take a look back at this year, specifically this year, to see which episodes had the most eyeballs, whether it was during the event during the episode live or afterwards, right? Both count in this game, in the content game. This is too much, Ryan. That's correct. But we're doing it live, and there's nothing you can do about it. So we thought it'd be interesting just to see, you know, who had the most eyeballs watching them, you know, and we limited it obviously to the times that we had a guest on, because there's plenty of times like this that we're creating such riveting content that, obviously this one's going to do numbers, but in any case, we figured we'd limit it just to the times we had guests, and that also gives us a chance to see, you know, who the people that we're interviewing have active social networks that are interested in what they're doing. So maybe they will find some value in this, at least our winners will, the rest of you. Got to get those numbers up.
Got to get back to work.
That's right. But so we figured we put together a little bit, of a leaderboard of sorts to see, right? Who nice. Did the best? Who has the most numbers? So let's start. What do you say we start?
Well, wait, with... Ryan, where exactly are we streaming this live right now?
That's a great question. I feel like I answered it earlier, and if you were paying attention, you'd know that. But Facebook and LinkedIn and YouTube. Oh, I see where you're going. I see where you're going with that. Mm. No, there's no and. Facebook, LinkedIn, and YouTube. We're doing those live.
Right. And so do we just have the three streams going out?
Yes. Is this a trick question?
Do we, though?
Yeah.
So the Facebook stream is actually going to another place as well.
Your Facebook page?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't get those numbers.
That's okay. They're probably going to be way higher than everybody else's. But I'm just saying, because the platform that we are using has the capabilities to go out to multiple sites, you need to consider where you're sending it as well. Mm. And in this case, if we're working on building, just say, our brands, then that is another way, is to add in your personal as well.
Right. Okay. Well, it's a great point.
That's all I got, so I'll just leave now.
I did drop the ball on that, but I also don't blame myself, because I didn't have access to your Facebook to figure out your analytics for these streams. So we're going to breeze past that. So forget everything that you just heard for the last several minutes. We are focusing on our corporate AV, Facebook, our LinkedIn, and our YouTube channels. And we're going to talk about who the leaders are in viewership and in whatever metrics that we can get our hands on, specifically in viewership and viewership and reach. So what do you think we should start with? Which channel?
I think we should start with YouTube. That's what I'm thinking.
Okay. Do you have any ideas on who the leaders are? We're going to do first place, second place, and third place. So,
can you make podium here? If I had to guess, I would say that there's probably a different winner in each platform.
Now, when you say winner, do you mean like the number one spot?
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Okay.
I mean, you know, I look at things as wins and losses. Okay. Like the Celtics winning last night in overtime over the Lakers. Mm-hmm. I mean, that had to happen.
You stayed up real late for that, didn't you?
I did. Unfortunately, it didn't end until 1 o'clock.
And then you were almost late for the show. So this is our...
Stay focused here. Oh, gosh. But anyway, I think that people have different audiences, and it depends on what platform they probably use.
That's true.
So I don't know. Let's see what YouTube's got to say.
All right. So here we go. We are going to look at the... They're all on one graphic because we didn't have enough time to separate them. So we are going to show now the first and second and third place of YouTube live view, or not just live, but viewership data. I'm drawing this out. I'm creating anticipation. Can you drum roll, please? Can you drum roll? I don't hear anything.
You missed it, man. Sorry.
All right, here we go. Drum roll. Da, 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 da. Boom! Okay. Out of left field. And when I say that, it's only because I didn't expect. I remember the conversation. And actually, Joe wasn't even involved in that conversation. Nope. So score one for me. Rob Friedland, our very own friend. He, I forget where in the world he is. I want to say in the Carolinas somewhere.
He's in Carolinas.
Enjoying his life. Rob Friedland, 160 views on his interview, which I got to say was a really, really enjoyable interview to have. And we were glad he was part of it. And there you go. You took the top spot as the number one most viewed, the Essential Ace YouTube video of AVX this year. So moving right along to number two, I actually did expect Melissa Andriou to make it into the podium at the very least here.
Andriou.
And of course, Melissa actually reposted this episode or at least shared it with her team at, I want to say, was it Dorfin Nelson? I think it was Dorfin Nelson. There we go. Nailed it. And they reposted this episode. So I can't factor in those views because it's not our channel. I don't have the metrics, just like Joe's Facebook. But there we go. Number two on our list of YouTube, Melissa Andriou. So thank you very much. A little golf clap. Okay.
Nice.
And
nice work.
In the bronze, third place, third in our podium here, but first in our hearts. Well, maybe that's not fair to say, but Maura DeRossi. Maura,
excellent work. Excellent.
Very good. 111 views. Golf clap. Golf clap. There we go. Okay. Well, that was exciting. We've never done anything like this before.
No, this is big time. Big time stuff.
Oh, man. All right. So that's YouTube.
Okay.
So who do we, where do we go next? I think maybe LinkedIn. What do you say?
All right. Let's go to LinkedIn.
Okay. So LinkedIn, and look, I got to ask, do you have any guesses here? Do you want to plug a name or two?
Well,
are you a betting man? I mean,
I'm not a betting man. Oh. LinkedIn is our largest follower base because of the clients that we serve are really professional clients in general. LinkedIn is our primary social media side. Hmm. So I'm willing to bet that it's someone related to a client.
Okay.
That would be my bet.
Wrong again. Here we go. LinkedIn, our first, second, and third place in viewership for AVX Live's episodes in 2022 are, drum roll.
Yeah, we're not doing the drum rolls today.
Come on, man. You're a drummer.
I know, but you didn't hear it when I did it before. So,
boom, there it is. Okay, in our top spot, which is why I wanted to point out that you were wrong, our most viewed LinkedIn Live. If I'm not mistaken, this was part of Pirate University. Am I wrong there?
That was Pirate University, and it was our AVX Live from Pirate University, which Ryan was not involved in.
That is correct. I was on vacation.
And I was literally running it, hosting it, and doing everything else while on stage. So okay, now, so I got to say, though, that was a great session. Hmm. It was really good. Omar, Ray, Jim were exceptional as they were really speaking to people in our industry about the things they could do to become experts in their craft. And the three of them are experts, and they did a great job. So it was a nice episode.
Absolutely. No, I completely agree. I did watch the replay, believe it or not, and I did find it to be very interesting. So
hopefully you learned something on how to be better at your craft.
I did. I learned a lot from this process. All right, so let's move on to number two, a familiar name. Again, in the number two spot, Melissa Andriou, 187 views. And again, this does not include the reposting and resharing. And I'm plugging that for a very important reason, because you're spending the time, you're having the interview, you're talking to us, with us, and hopefully there's a valuable conversation or valuable exchange of info. Repost it. Come on, people. Let's go. Share it. Be part of the show, too. That's great. All right, so there we go. So there's first and second, and then number three.
Ooh, Kelly.
Kelly Teglis. Right. There we go.
Kelly Teglis Events. And Kelly's been a longtime client, event planner, has her own company. We've worked with her several other organizations in the past. And I'm not surprised by that. She had some really good insight on how to help people plan their events. And that would be, all of these are episodes I would strongly encourage people to go back and watch.
There we go. Well said. Okay. So there you go. First, second, and third.
Fantastic. Cough clap. Bravo. Bravo.
Well done.
Bravissimo.
Yes. Bravissimo. All right. So do you want to pause before we go to Facebook?
No way, Matt.
No, we're going to just power right through.
Right through, just like when I was driving back.
This is live. Okay. Here we go. So Facebook, and I can tell you actually because I've seen the numbers already. Facebook, the top slot. And of course, we don't really measure up based on reach for Facebook. For views on Facebook, it's measured in reach. And the reach numbers are definitively the highest on Facebook. And I think I know, I have a pretty good sense of why that might be. And I'm going to talk about it in just a second. But here we go. Drum roll that Joe's not going to do.
I mean, can I at least guess? The other times I got to guess.
Your guesses were terrible. But go ahead.
Wait a minute. How are they terrible?
You said it was going to be a client, and you were wrong. And
one of them was a client.
Yeah, one of them.
Not in the top slot. Well, actually, one of them is a client.
You also said that you thought that each channel was going to be different, and Melissa showed up twice. Wrong again.
Okay, I might have been wrong on that. On this one, I happen to have a strong suspicion at who's at the top.
He knows the answer.
Because of the platform that they spend a lot of their time on and that they developed an entire channel for. Hmm. So I would be willing to bet that it's someone related to AV Educate. What?
I think I know who that is.
Just a guess of mine.
Okay, here we go. Facebook, our top honors, first, second, and third place for the year 2022 is, boom, Omar Colom of AV Educate with a whopping reach of 2,200. That's a lot.
Yeah.
Wow. That's pretty good. Well, of course, AV Educate has quite a following in its own right. So I suspect that some of those may come from there. But Omar obviously is a very well-known individual in this space, and another great conversation, and so deservedly so in the top spot, Omar Colom, 2,200.
Bravo.
Bravo.
Wow. That's
all right.
Incredible.
It is incredible. Also incredible is the individual in the number two slot here. Joe, do you know this guy?
I do.
Who is
this guy, Artie Dillon, is unbelievable. I mean, he is a master of many crafts. So right now he's probably actually loading a truck in our warehouse, but he is a top musician, one of the best in the area, and a fantastic human being. And so I am not surprised at all
that
he is.
Joe, you forgot one important detail that's related to this.
As lead guitarist of Wireless Mike and the Analogs?
I'm glad you said that, but that's not what I was getting at. He also is a content creator in his own right. He has a video podcast among other things that he gets involved with. But he spends a lot of time on the road and backstage and playing shows and playing with a lot of well-known musicians, and he documents his experiences online. So definitely go check out Artie Dillon on the socials, and you can see what he's working with. But I also suspect that that is why his reach numbers are so high, is because he's doing this thing too. So there you go. Well done. Well done, Artie, number two.
Well, and you know, just to that point, right?
Yeah.
AV Educate, they have just about 5,000 members or followers on their page. Artie by himself has over 1,200.
It's pretty good.
I mean, these are big numbers.
Absolutely.
And, you know, that's part of the reason that people are interested in what they have to say.
For sure. Well, speaking of things that people have to say, let's go to our number three spot on Facebook is, which doesn't really come as a surprise, just considering the space he's in, Mr. Ronnie Ram of,
yes.
It's Inspiria, right? Am I blowing it?
Inspiria Outdoor, yeah.
There we go. Oh, man, I did 2 for 2. Nice. With a reach of 480. Well done, Ronnie. Another great conversation, another great individual. And there we go. A very nice, well-rounded top three, top podium. There we go for Facebook.
That's pretty nice. Very nice.
Golf clap.
And he
there
is
we go.
Also involved in the media space. And
he is indeed.
Content creation and, in his case, outdoor media. I'm pretty sure he actually has some trucks that drive around right now, too. And you can put your message on some LED trucks that drive around. But
that's
Times
right.
Square, he controls a lot of the media that goes on the big screens in Times Square and many, many other places.
Yeah. Beautiful.
Pretty cool. Pretty cool.
So there we go. Joe, what'd you think about doing our year wind down here?
I think that I like the surprises, number one.
There's one more.
I like the surprises. I like the different players and different platforms. I think that's going to help us to identify some things as we try to move forward with the podcast and in our own internal marketing.
Right.
And I don't know. I think it's pretty cool.
I do too. And Joe, I got to summarize what I feel we've learned. Oh, wait, hold on. Before we go into that, Mr. Rob Friedland, humbled to be the king of YouTube. Yes, book it. Essential Ace, comma, king of YouTube.
The Essential Ace.
Boom.
I didn't get to retype yet.
You didn't get to retype. Oh, no, that's okay. That's okay. There it is. Okay. But before I was going to, before I got into that, I was going to say there is a takeaway here that we've learned.
Tell us more.
I will, but first I have to lower the music. Now, I think we should really just do a quick wrap up just in case they cut us off for this one, because it's definitely copyright infringement. Here it comes. Sayonara, have a great day. But this is what we learned from doing the analytics.
Those are rookie numbers in this racket.
One more time.
Those numbers up. Those are rookie numbers in this racket.
Wow.
There we go.
Rookie numbers.
Those are rookie numbers.
So you think that those aren't good enough. Is that what you're saying?
I think that it's a good start, but see, when we look at the line graph, what we're looking for is something like this.
This is embarrassing.
Okay? This is the line graph that we're looking for. Okay?
It's not much of a visual.
Well, I didn't have another one prepared, so.
Is there a whiteboard on this thing? I mean, can I draw on this?
Let's see. No.
Oh, I thought there might have been. They've
if anybody
so
from
much.
StreamYard is watching, we would very much like a whiteboard so that we can visualize our sometimes stupidity. Actually, maybe no whiteboard.
No whiteboard.
No,
because I'll be drawing on it the entire time.
Yeah.
But I think you're right. There's a lot of room for improvement, and there's a lot of ways to use the material to help your organization and to help your guests in our case, because our guests are really like our clients.
Right.
And we want to be able to help them and improve their reach and their marketing. And you know, that is part of the reasons that we have certain people on, so that they can work on getting themselves out there or getting their message out there.
Absolutely. And I mean, look, we've had a lot of messages from agricultural investing to DEIB and everything in between. I think we have some platform. We would like it to be larger. We're working on that. If you would like, comment, share, and subscribe.
I wasn't ready.
There we go. Then it'd be a little easier. But we're doing this thing organically here, folks. So
that's okay. That's how you learn. You know, I don't think we anticipated some of these things when we first started.
No.
And we've learned a lot. It's been a lot of fun. I gotta say, I do enjoy it, you know, and you know, we just gotta keep getting better. So we've set some new goals for 2023.
That's right.
And you know, we're actually gonna release a little poll. We'll put that out in social media.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that.
To see what people actually want to hear about. And then we'll gather our guests and some talent based on that. So that it's not just our wonderful faces.
Right. Well, I mean, and that's pretty good too, but apparently it doesn't carry enough.
As they say, this is too much Ryan.
This is too much Ryan. I agree. Wow. All right. Well, why don't we give them less Ryan? What do you say?
I think that, look, we're gonna do a little holiday thing soon.
Oh, yeah.
And see, this is my way of making less Ryan. I can shrink you now into a smaller box.
That is less Ryan. That is true.
Thank you.
Yeah. That looks really nice, Joe.
Oh, well, thanks. You know, they're actually building this right now as our party's going to happen this Saturday. So, you know, if you want to hit like, subscribe, we might be able to send you an invitation. You don't hit like, subscribe, you're out. That's it.
There will be a dance battle. So factor that in.
Wow, that's big time. That is big time.
You had a whole bunch of pictures. You only showed one.
No, that's all I showed. That's all I got for today.
Okay, fine.
No. We'll save the others for after the party.
That actually will be a good show. We'll do the holiday party recap.
You know, there you go.
Or the lampshade on their head.
I think it's going to be...
Ah, in your face.
Blew it. That is so hard to get right on one try.
Yes, it is.
But look, this seems like a perfect time to wrap up. You know, we have one more show of the year. It's probably going to be a little fun as well. And then we're going to get our lineup going already for our guests for 2023. But we are going to post some things on social. So feel free to comment and, you know, give us your input. Let's see what direction you'd like to have information going. Because our goal is to always have people tell us about how they're using technology so others can learn. But Mr. Finch, I think this seems like a perfectly good time for us to wrap up.
I would have to agree with you. So just a reminder, you can find us on Facebook.
Oh, wow. I wasn't
You're ready. So behind. Facebook, on LinkedIn, on YouTube Live. You can do that every Wednesday or at least 37 Wednesdays. 37 out of 52. 70% of Wednesdays, we're doing it. At 1 p.m.
Evan, we've done 35 this year. Next week is 36.
35 plus this. Okay, I see what I did there. The 70 bled into the number in my brain. I don't have it written down. Okay. There's no script on this one. 35 Wednesdays out of 52. That's 70% roughly. You can find us on Facebook, LinkedIn, and YouTube Live at 1 o'clock. If you missed that, you can find little bite-sized pieces. I feel like there's going to be some bite-sized pieces from this on Facebook and on Instagram. I think that would be a pretty smart move. Hint, hint.
That was to
Alexa so that she can chop these up. Is
she even watching?
Probably not. probably not. Well, she didn't drop a comment. So do we know if you're watching, if you don't drop a comment? Speaking of, drop a comment. Be part of the show. Let us know what you want to hear about. Ask a question. We're doing it live. You might as well.
And, I mean, what's the worst that could happen?
Let's not get into that. And then, of course, you can also like, comment, share, subscribe. All of the above.
Bam!
Very helpful. And if you do all of that, and if all your people do all of that, you may find yourself on one of these banners right here next year in 2023 that I promise I won't figure out 30 seconds before we went live.
Well, very good. Nice job today, Ryan. We appreciate the analytics and the work. And, you know, wait till we put these numbers up next year. At this time next year, we're blowing that thing away.
I agree. That's the plan.
All right. Time to wrap this thing up.
Can I wrap this one up?
All right. Go for it.
All right. Take care, everyone. Bye-bye. Ciao, ciao.
I'm not saying it. See you later, everyone.
Say it.
Enjoy. We're never saying that.
Stay golden, pony boy.
Nope.